The mechanism we're looking at right now is what's called a lead screw, or a lead screw, depending on how you choose to pronounce it. So a lead screw has a single screw, okay, which is exactly what it looks like. It's like the threads off of a screw that you'd screw into a wall on a drive axle. In this case, the drive axle, I've got a little handle, and that's our motor source. And on this lead screw is a follower, basically. And what this is a threaded piece of material that could be connected to anything. In this case, it's just connected to another piece of plastic. And so what the lead screw does is that as you rotate it, because this piece is not allowing it to spin with the screw, it actually makes it slide along with the actual motion. So what's the point of this? What does it do? Well, the big application is that it allows you to change motion. So my input motion in this case is rotary. I'm spinning the actual axle. So imagine there's a motor here that's causing it to spin. Now, the actual resulting motion, instead of being rotational, is actually linear. It's allowing this piece to just move forwards and back. And depending on how good your motor is and how well it's set up, you can actually control how far back and forth this piece goes very, very precisely. If you've ever seen a 3D printer run, the little motors are called stepper motors, and they essentially are lead screws or lead screws that drive where the extruder is on your 3D printer. But the main goal of one of these is to convert rotary motion into linear motion. Now, these lead screws obviously here is very short, it's only a couple of units long, but you could build these incredibly long however you wanted to. It depends on what your goal is. But it's basically used to move something back and forth between two places. And so that's a lead screw, and it just, again, allows you to transfer rotational motion into linear motion. That is its primary focus.